In this class, we have discussed about the VBA macro programming and topics the data types and variables. When you see the any program, and you can also see the many example of VBA programming on Google, you can realize that we somewhere have a defined R as an integer, yeah, R as a long, R as a string, whatever. So what is this R as an integer? Because this is a temporarily saving location of your system. DIM, it means dimension. In the your hard disk dimension, store the create the one locations. Name is the R, and R store the value the integer. Why need? First, if in the VBA, when you type the macro, need to some store the temporarily calculations, temporarily data, and we need to further the next line of the code. That time we use the this type of variable. Just like I have get the one information from the user, so we have need to use the code input box, right? Input box, and we have a type the enter the number. But input box, where store your number? Input box need to the locations. Need to the locations. So if you have not used the variable, you can write the range. Is that range a one dot value? Right, sir. Okay, but problem is that if your range a one not free, already store the another value on the range one. That time have to override the your input value, right? And problem is that your macro work for the different workbooks, so need to the open the workbook and open the sheets also. So some if you have used the your sheet range, have a problem. So we have used here the variable just like n, but I have not defined the n. Now is working, because if you not define the m directly, define the variant. But if you have the use the casting, need to define a dim n as a integer. What is the integer? Integer have the data types. So first know about what is the this line of the code. How can declare? We have declared the dim for dimension and write the name as a your cast. It means data types. Why use? We have need to the store the temporarily hold in the value in the VBA macro, and also you want to know about your application name. So we have typed here active workbook dot name. So it means that this is the property give the information where store your value. So we have need to here fn equal to at least a value, but need to define the fn. It is fn as a string. So why use the string? Because active workbook dot name is the text, so a string category will be stored as a text. So we have defined a string and store the name, and anywhere I want to use this, it's like I want to use this number n, we can also apply P equal to n multiply by 100 divided by 90. So when the store when the run the input box is not the number, and we have enter the number 100, then it is the 100 multiply 100 divided by 90. So we have used this like mathematics. If you use the mathematics x y z and x equal to 100, and where we need 200, we use the x in any calculations. Same like that we have used it. So what is a variable and how can why use the variable? It is clear, Mr. Veera?
Hello. Yeah, clear.
Okay. Now we have know about our variables. So I have sent the book. In the book have a page number 199. This is the 199 page number. We have the table of the variables. Right, sir. So we have the byte, boolean, integer, okay. Long, single, double, currency, decimal, date, objects, string, variant. and user defined. So one by one we discuss about that. So first a small value is the byte. It denotes B as a byte. So, but the problem is that before the declaration, understand the declarations. Why we define? I have also show you. I have directly entered your P equal to 100. No need to define the P. Because if you not define to P, your system will be automatically defined as a variant. But some problem here, we have the two types of the problem. First, the conversion. Just like we have the data in the decimals. I want to remove the decimals. So if you have not defined your variables, so then need to use the round formula. Round formula for the remove your round down formula, remove your decimals. But if you just define here dim p as a integer never store the decimal value. If you have want to store the decimal value, then convert the integer and then store. So require the conversion of your data, just like decimal to string, decimal to long, and the string to date, we have used the define the decimal process. Second thing, global variable. We have I want to create the 2 and 3 macro, and I want to use one variable to every macro. That time you need to declare. And next is when we have used the create the formula, and formula asks your declaration macro. So if you have created a small macro, that time you can never require for the create your define your the data types. But you have to create the complicated macros and need to the conversions and need to the formula. That time we use the define your variables. Mr. Vida, it is clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hello.
Tell me.
Just tell me how it works, global variable.
Okay, I tell you, but I just give the information. First, read the normal variable, then use the global variable.
Okay.
So first is the byte. B is the byte. You can store the value 0 to 255 without decimal and without negatives. Because your byte value, you store a value 0 to 255. Second, dim BL as a boolean. Boolean is the store at true and false. If you have typed the boolean equal to true and false, give the drop down. So one thing here is that if you have want to store true and false value, you can also store on the integer n as a integer, and you have type here n equal to true and false, because one is the true and zero is the but if you have defined the boolean value, when they place the equal, you can give the auto suggestion. One benefit again for the define the variables. It is clear? It's clear? Mr. Mina, have a problem any?
Clear.
Okay. Next is the integer. Integer, if you have the data greater than 255 and you have the negative data, then you can define the integer if it I as an integer and I equal to, we have typed the numbers. So integer take the minus 30,762 to plus 13,767 only. Without decimals, like that. And if you have the greater than data from the integers, like we have typed 40,000, 40,000 is the outer limit, because integer limit is the minus 30,768 to 30,767. But we have want to store the 40,000, then need to use the long. We have the long here. So dim L as a long, and you can type here many value, but you have one to the store in the decimals, long not stored as a decimals. But one thing, here is a single one single error. Then do you have is want to value have a problem with your long, because long also the greatest value, but in future if we have the more than long value, then we have store as a single. Single have a more capacity from the your long, but single is not used because we have the long is the sufficient. But we have required the store the decimal places. The decimal places only for store in as a d as a double. So you have write any value in the double. Double store the decimal places, store the negative value, store the greater than single and long also. So if you have a confusion, if what type of the data will receive, maybe decimal, maybe integer, maybe long, you can just write here double. And you have want to store your date. So we have defined here dt as a date. Date and time. Only for date, no, no date and time. So if you have write the date in the text format, it's like 1 Jan 2019. DT as a convert this text to as a date. So we have use a day for date we use here. Next is I want to store the non-calculative data. It means text. Date also calculative. So I want to store the any value. It's called non-calculative. It can also text, but you can also store the number in the text format. So we call the non-calculative data. We use the n as a ss as a string. A string. Here. And you can type here anything in the inverted comma, store the value as a text. No limit, no space. Because limit is the very greater, right here, string. 2 billion character. We have the limit is the 2 billion character. 2 billion character is the very okay. So now we have some problem. I want to define the variables, but no idea about the storage value, because a storage value depending on the data, depending on the user and situation. So I have no idea our data as a long, as a string, just like use the VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP, lookup also text, lookup also value, lookup also date, lookup also true and false also. So some problem, how can I use the variables in the VLOOKUP type of formula and options? So right here, variant, dim V as a variant. Variant is the convert according the storage data. If you, we have stored the data in the number, variant convert the number, and we have stored the data V as a string, V equal to a string. So convert as a string, and V equal to date, so convert as per date. So variant equal to all rounder. So Bisabira, it is clear about the your variables. We have the variables byte, boolean, integer, long, single, double, date, string, and variant. Any doubts from the object? Hello.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And now we have problem, we have the one all-rounder. It means variant. If variant, if you store the number, variant comma the number, so why use the this type of the value? Use directly variant. Right, sir? So if you on book, see here the used byte. If you then the create your macro, define your variables, consume the one space or some space in your hard disk and your RAM. When you're creating the space, creating the variables, consuming the some space on your hard disk and RAM, and a space according to the variant. So if you use the byte, consume the one bytes. If you boolean 2 bytes, integer 2 bytes, long 4 bytes, single 4 bytes, double 8 bytes, currency 8, decimal 12 bytes. So we have see here is the variant is a 60 byte or also byte wide. Variant is the numbers, so 16 byte and byte, those 22 bytes. But why do mine? I have one TV, one and a half TV, hard disk, 8 GB RAM. This is the byte. It is small. But problem is that we have the limitation about the one subject. If you create the one subject MM have a limit for the space consuming 255 KB. So if you create the long macro, big macro, and create the multiples more than 100 to 200 variables in the your macros, that time have a problem. If you use the variant, maybe increase your 255 KB limits. So remind that. Now you have also, if you have created some small macro, you can use the variant, no problem. But one problem in thing, you have conversions. Just like you have typed the in decimals, number in the decimals, variant not to convert in the not convert and not rounded, because then that you have typed the decimal, store the decimals, variant convert to the decimal, doubles. So you have three, then use, right, sir?
Yeah.
So next, this is the data type. Second, the object type variables. So we discuss the object type variables. Just like we have also create dim R as a, it's like R as a range, and you can set the one specific range R equal to range.
Yeah, what is the use of the set, sir?
In the future classes, we discuss about the class module. In the class module, you can declare the undefined variables.
Mm-hmm.
So in future, we have discussed.
Okay.
So I have created the R equal to range, and range 8, 10 to 20 we assigned. Now we have do anything for range A1 to N20. So if we use the dynamic range, do you remember I have discussed about the dynamic selections? So when you use the dynamic selections will be very complicated and take the 2-3 lines. That time, if you this area you have used the multiple sensors, you can use the in the filter, the pivot, in the different features in the one macros, need 2 and 3 lines, write the every code, every the code. So we have define the range, and we have just assigned and used. Also, we have the WAJ workbook. Also, we can use the set W equal to active workbooks, and also dim as a S as a sheet. Yeah, worksheet, you can also write here worksheet. And S equal to active worksheets. So we have also defined one particular object, just like D major pivot. We have in future we have discussed about more of the object thinking. We can also define the object dim O as a object. And need to create the other application here. Okay, set W equal to create object. Just like you want to open the outlook dot applications. So this time, this is the we have covering the next future classes, but we have discussed how can create use the object. So we have the also we have created any range, any workbook, any sheets, and any what you want to connect and open your other application like Outlook, it's like Word, it's like a Notepad. We use the create object or use the object data types. So this features we use in the future classes for the example, but I just here explain you. And you can also define the one word, just like we have set new sheet equal to sheets dot add, and we want to define the sheet. We have used the ns with ns dot name equal to dot move sheets so we use it. So we have not defined only for the your object. We can also define the one action. This is like seat add is the actions. We have defined the set ns is the seat add, and we have do the some action, another action. This is like seat change the name, move the your seat everywhere. Right, sir?
Okay.
Now we have discussed about the global variable. We have the two macros. I want to use one macro to just like we have a sub, and this is the I want to create the rate dim R as a MRP as a long. Cost as a and we have the sub to dim amount as a so I want to we have create here I want to the create the MRP so MRP equal to cost multiply by 0.20 plus cost, and that I have defined the cost equal to 50 rupees. Right, sir? And I want to create amount in this quantity. Yes, Q2Y and QTY equal to 50. I want to create an amount here. Amount equal to QTY multiply by MR. Right, sir? So we have the two macro. One macro calculate the MRP, a second macro calculate the amount. Understand, sir?
Yeah.
A problem is that in dim AMP as a problem is that we have created the MRP, the one macro, other macro. So this macro need to store MRP in the another location, because this macro never consider the variables from the another macro. Because this temporary saving locations, if you stop your macro and your data will be deleted, your variable also will be deleted.
Sir, MRP is a variable, right?
Yeah, amount is a amount. First of all, we have the cost 50 rupees, and MRP is the 20% at the your cost. That's like cost multiplied 20% plus cost. Just like if you have 100 rupees MRP a cost, then MRP is the 120, right? But this information is stored in our macro. Then I have the quantity. Tell me.
But we are not declaring MRP anywhere, right?
This is the problem. Because if we have defined the MRP in this macro, it named MRP as a long or anything. But problem problem is that I have defined MRP. This MRP is the variable of the RR macro. Never considered to RR2 macro. So need to store this calculation on the your range, and then consider here from the range. And I don't want to use the range. We have a problem using the range. That time we use the global macro. So simple, we have declared the global macro starting of the your macro. So your global macro is not in any subject. That time we have here is the type, your MSG box, and there is the amount. See here, we have run this macro. First run the macro R1, and now we have run the second macro. You can get the report.
Okay.
So MRP, we use the MRP from the one. So if you have write the more than one and two macros, and one variable, you want to use the one variable calculation in the another subject, that we use the global variables. Okay, sir. Please read your books. I have sent your books. Open the page number 199, and one day also read the 199. Also read the another 5 page also, because there is the use of the variables. So you can understand you are using the variables. So tomorrow we discuss about the array data types, array variables. So one variables is the missing array. We discuss the next classes.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me.
In if condition.